Now you know that in human body there are various organ systems like
digestive system, respiratory system, excretory system, circulatory system, nervous system, etc.
Today let's know more about respiratory system. Before we study this system, I have few questions for you. Think and answer. Do all human beings breathe? Yes, we all humans breathe. When do we breathe? That is, during day or night? We breathe during day as well as night. It means breathing is a continuous process that is involuntary. It does not occur according to our wish. We breathe even in sleep. And now the last question. Can you imagine if a person stops breathing or is unable to breathe? In such situation, the person may even die if he fails to breathe for a long time. You need to understand how is this process important for our body. Students, during breathing, we take in air rich of oxygen. This is called inhalation. This oxygen is supplied to various body cells and it is used to oxidize food that we eat.
Thus, finally, food energy gets trapped in adenosine triphosphate or ATP molecules.
Our body uses these ATP molecules to perform various functions and activities. Hence, respiration must occur continuously for constant supply of energy. Now, let's study respiratory system of man. Respiratory system consists of organs like nose, nasal cavity, pharynx, windpipe or trachea, lungs and diaphragm. Nose. Respiratory system begins with nose. We breathe through nostrils. Air that we get is filtered. Air becomes warm inside the nose. Also, we are able to detect smell as there are specialized cells present in nose. Pharynx. The air inhaled through nose passes to pharynx. In simple words, we can say that pharynx means throat region of the body.
Food pipe and windpipe open in pharynx.
At the opening of windpipe, there is a lid. When we swallow food, this lid remains closed. Thus, food moves to food pipe correctly, not to the windpipe by mistake. Otherwise, this lid is open for entry of air into windpipe. Windpipe. It is also called as trachea. Trachea is swollen at the beginning due to sound box or larynx. Usually, our windpipe is 12 cm long. In the thorax or chest region of body, trachea produces two branches. One branch enters the right lung and other into left lung. Lungs. There are a pair of lungs in our body. One is right lung and other is left lung. These lungs are present in thoracic cavity or chest cavity on either side of heart. Students, do you know that right lung is larger in size than the left one? This is because the left lung shares space of thoracic cavity with heart. Hence, it is smaller in size. Lungs are spongy, elastic bag-like organs. Each lung has a protective double layer called pleura. Inside each lung, there are numerous small spherical air sacs called alveoli. Alveoli are surrounded by a network of blood capillaries. Oxygen from alveoli and carbon dioxide from capillaries are exchanged in lungs. This is how blood gets purified or oxygenated in lungs. Diaphragm. Diaphragm is located at the base of thoracic cavity. It is a muscular partition that moves upwards and downwards during respiration. So, this was about our respiratory system. Now, we will study the actual mechanism of respiration in brief or what actually happens when we respire. To understand this mechanism well, I will divide it into three steps. Step 1, breathing. Step 2, exchange of gases in lungs and cells. Step 3, use of oxygen to produce ATP molecules. Breathing. This process involves inhalation and exhalation. During inhalation, we take oxygen-rich air through nose and send it to lungs through windpipe. When we inhale, the diaphragm is lowered, ribs are lifted upwards and outwards. Due to this, volume of thoracic cavity increases, but air pressure in the cavity decreases. Thus, air from outside enters lungs. Now, exactly opposite events occur when we exhale air. This air is rich in carbon dioxide, which moves out through nose. During exhalation, diaphragm becomes dome-shaped or convex. Ribs return to original position. Thus, volume of thoracic cavity decreases and air pressure inside increases. As a result, air moves out of the body. The second step of exchange of gases can be divided into two parts, namely external respiration and internal respiration. External respiration means oxygen and carbon dioxide get exchanged in lungs. Oxygen from alveoli gets added to blood and carbon dioxide from blood moves into alveoli. Thus, blood gets purified or oxygenated. Hemoglobin from blood combines with oxygen and transports it to different organs. Internal respiration takes place at the level of cells. Oxygen from blood is supplied to body cells and carbon dioxide from cells enters blood.
In the last step of respiration, oxygen is used to oxidize food. Thus, food energy gets trapped into ATP molecules. This is called cellular respiration.
Summary. Human respiratory system consists of organs like nose, pharynx, windpipe or trachea, lungs and diaphragm. The process of respiration takes place in stepwise manner. In the first step, oxygen is inhaled in the lungs and carbon dioxide is exhaled out through nose. This is called inhalation and exhalation. The second step involves external and internal respiration. In the external respiration, oxygen is added to blood in the lungs and carbon dioxide is exhaled out. Blood supplies oxygen to cells during internal respiration and finally, in the cellular respiration, ATP molecules are produced. Now, there is a small exercise for you. Which are the respiratory organs in cockroach, fish, snake, and frog?